isn't around anymore. That can be for lots of reasons, but it can also be because they passed away, because we're a large enough community that that happens. There's a significant number each year. So this is when we remember that stuff. And Sky Beauty, I just remembered your husband, and that's thank you for reminding me. He was a great guild member that we all really liked, and it was really sad to see him go after the struggle. But I'm glad you're still here with us.
Dianides entered channel.
And I hear you're going to BlizzCon this year, so hopefully you get to hug a lot of people there.
Yay, hug.
I also wanted to say, sometimes there's other people too that maybe haven't passed away, but we have, you know, we've been around for a while. Channel. And I can think of raid groups and people that I played with back in Burning Crusade who have moved on to other things. Maybe they play other games. Maybe they'll be coming back for Legion. So I was also thinking that in addition to thinking about people who have passed away, I think now is a good time to think about groups that we used to play with and maybe we'll play with again. So right now I'll mention a couple of raid teams that I was really fond of. One was the Over the Hill Gang. I still hang out with some of those folks, but a lot of them I haven't seen in quite a while. And we raided Karazhan and Nax and sort of that time frame. And then the other group was a group called Guppers, which stood for Gruel and Unusual Punishment. And that was a Friday night sort of pickup group inside the guild. And we ran and fought against Gruel. And that one was also a lot of fun. And I miss both those groups a lot. And anybody now that wants to talk about groups or people that they used to run with, that they hope to run with again, you can go ahead and feel free to do that.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I was going to say, just because I need to skedaddle really quick, because I need to go run down to the school. Circle of Power. That old raid group who used to start, we actually started up at Karazhan and kind of gave us the mem for a little bit about Gwen Stefani and raiding music, as we used to oftentimes make fun of Tark, who used to be the raid team leader.
Oh, and they became Drunk with Power, right?
Yeah, Drunk with Power. So that was a fantastic time. And that itself spawned out about three other different raid groups, like Undercity Debt Collectors and
Drunk with Power 2, as I recall.
Drunk with Power 2, and I think there was a Drunk with Power 3 for a while. And I guess some of their shenanigans led to the raid team Filthy Casuals, which was really funny because that ended up being a meme and a response to someone who was on the forum who was being a bit of a jerk.
I remember all of those co-op runs. Thanks to get our bears.
Oh, the coop runs. Yes, creamy orange otter pop.
There's one this Friday.
Oh, I gotta do that again.
And SJ's here. I should have mentioned, I was actually down your part of town earlier today.
And you didn't stop in for a hug. I'm offended.
I am sorry. I was on a time constraint. I was meeting up. I was meeting up with Jay Baxter.
Totally understandable.
But next time.
Anytime.
All right, everybody's being shy. Anybody else have something? Oh, Brew?
Yeah, just to remember my friend Borgaz, who ran with me on with Raid Wipers Anonymous and also was a member of four Tanks. Borgaz was a Marine veteran, and then what we didn't know was he was actually taking care of his mother quite a bit, and then unfortunately himself was, had a sudden onslaught and then died quickly from cancer. And this was about almost 4 years ago. So we always think about him. He had always had a little quirks. He didn't call it Orgrimmar. He called it Orgrimmar and a lot of different things. And I recently started playing WoW again and went to send an email from Winalt to my main Brewdog. And of course, the first thing that populated by my mail add-on was Borgaz rather than
because Brew of your Dogs, friends list.
Right, from my friend list. That was kind of, yeah, it's nice. I see little memories of, remembrances of him every once in a while. So that's good to see that, you know. So anyway.
Please excuse me, folks. I need to step away. So I will hopefully get a chance to log in later. Perhaps some of you will still be on.
Thank you for joining us, Link. We appreciate your time.
My pleasure.
See you, Link.
Thank you.
But kind of as part of that, it's a good idea to make sure that someone else in your, that, you know, a wife or a friend or a parent or something like that, that, you know, knows you, is has your information to be able to log in or to let everybody know when something happens to you. Because, you know, there's probably people that, you know, we know and talk to that just disappear, and because they haven't set something like that up, you may never hear about it. So it's good to, you know, kind of have something, so, you know, if you get sick or if, you know, something happens, you know, heaven forbid, there's a way to let all of your online friends know.
Somewhat slightly off topic, but I was in a raid with someone who went into a diabetic coma, and because the raid leader had some contact info for her, and we were able to reach a roommate who checked on her and got her to the hospital in time.
Excellent.
That's really good to hear.
Well, normally during this time, we'd be sort of forming up and starting our march towards Orgrimmar. But I'm still at the connecting screen, so I don't know how many people are at the Shrine of the Fallen Warrior.
We have 33 people in the raid right now.
Do you guys want to go ahead and start walking?
We can wait for you, Ralph.
I don't know how long it'll be. I keep getting in and out.
I just got in, Ralph, so I don't know if that's will help you or not. I haven't been able to log in, but I just got in.
Yep, so did I.
So since we're all waiting for Ralph, hi guys, this is Zeph. How you doing?
Hey, Zephy, thanks for joining us.
Mm-hmm. I actually just want to touch on my grandfather real quick. He died last month. A year and a week to the day of my grandmother passing away. So the last year has been a little bit rough for grandparents, because he was the last living guy, or gentleman, grandfather in my family. So that's been a little bit hard, but logging into games, seeing you guys, gives me a reason to smile every day. So I would like to extend that thank you for you guys, because I don't think you guys realize just how much you are family to me. Seeing Ellen and Grimm and all you guys, it's amazing. And seeing the CTR side of this too, they've been wonderful. They've been just as much part of my family as you guys are, so thank you.
You are most welcome.
We enter channel.
Hello, Zeph.
Hey, honey.
Do you know who that is?
Yeah.
Buxley enter channel.
I'm sorry, but hey, baby, I gotta gush here for a second. Hi, honey. I love you, Logo. You're cool.
Thanks.
You've got mail.
We have Chasen on Twitch said they can't log in, but they're with us in spirit.
Cool. This is probably the most virtual Remembrance Day we've ever had, given the conditions in WoW tonight.
Yep.
But you know what? Run list.
It doesn't matter. It's the event that counts, not where you are.
Exactly.
Oh, and by the way, Grim, thank you for being around, buddy. I really appreciate you.
Aw, thank you.
He should get a mumble room.
I still have bags full of cloth, thanks to you.
Oh, you're very welcome. Like, I still have to work on my priest on this side because I moved Zeph over, but... Or the original Zeph over.
But I don't so have... I don't have 8 banks full of cloth, thanks to you.
Ugh. I think I covered a good slot for you.
The last craft fair before before the 200 stacks came out, I was 5 banks plus 3 borrowed.
I remember you borrowed one of my banks.
and full mailboxes. I had to borrow one of Siddhar's banks.
Yeah, I think you threatened me with it, too. Like, if you send me one more stitch of cloth, I'm taking your bank.
Oh, it's delightful. It's too bad the craft fair has kind of gone by the wayside. Hopefully we can do something about it in Legion.
Yeah, I'm always willing, you know, once I get tunes up for professions and stuff next expansion, if anybody ever needs anything that I have excess of, you know, I give it away if it's not soulbound.
I may have made some shirts for people to be fabulous.
Because you're fabulous!
Really? There's only one banner out?
Oh, I could fix that.
Because usually there's...
Colin, invite me.
Usually there's I'm more full. banners and horde balloons. We're full. We're at full 40.
Telenroid entered channel.
I think I left my banner in my other pants.
It's in your toy box.
Well, stop me if
Is that where it is now?
I'm going off topic, but I just recently joined back in on the Sword Horse side, and I haven't been active in AIE for years, and I have to say it really touched me when I talked to someone who actually remembered me from all those years back. It made me realize how awesome the people in this guild are, that, you know, they remembered me after all that time.
Was that Rick last night?
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, Rick Naozi, I remember him from early days of SWTOR. Great guy.
I want to thank the SWTOR crew for taking Grimcow's little barely 65 in greens on the fun run last Tuesday.
Thanks for coming.
I also got to thank everybody, two especially people in WoW who have helped me out in these past 5 days of joining the WoW crew. And both had someone become my trustee and someone who became my dungeon runner and helped me out getting that first dungeon done. It's nice to see
you there, Peters.
It's nice to see, thank you. It's nice to see how, like, I do that in SWTOR for new people, but to see the same type of people in AIE and in WoW do the same thing. Like, yeah, don't worry about it. Come on, let's go. And it's not like Diablo with random people where they rush you through things. It's like, yeah, take your time. This is where you need to go. Don't forget to get this chest. Don't forget to loot. Did you get everything you need?
Don't stand in that.
Yeah.
By the way, SWTORs, if any of you have 90 or above and you're interested in getting a Warbear, come on by on Friday. We're running Coop.
Yes. Yeah, that's...
Thanks for the invite.
That's a great idea. So we've got that on Friday. In Star Wars, on Saturday, we're going to have a big guild party for anybody that's got a character in Star Wars that wants to stop by. We're going to do stronghold tours, costume contest, and a little bit of a dance party, and maybe some prizes. I did want to say thank you to everybody that came out in Star Wars for our Remembrance Day today. I know we've got some new people that have never been here before. I see we have almost 25 people here in a line. We've got some pictures here of everyone kneeling down.
Nice.
I know just over the years, I've talked to various people from that have been in the guild, new to the guild, old to the guild, and this kind of event where we do something real and important and talk about, you know, our friends and what the guild means to us really sets AIE apart, and I really appreciate that, so... I'm glad we do this.
Thanks, Max. Good podcast,
Max,
by the way.
Max is one of those that plays every single game.
I'm in only in two tonight. I've been in three games for Remembrance Day in the past, so.
Yeah, the important distinction there is he plays them at the same time.
I know we have plans for Lord of the Rings to get the band back together before long, so I'm looking forward to that too.
I think
literally
plays...
the band?
Yes.
Yeah, the band, yeah.
Sorry, no Pell, no band.
We gotta, well, Pell, if we start up the band,
Pell will
join.
Come.
Yeah, he will come.
So if we string it, he will come.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
No Pell, no band, no justice, no peace.
I have a question for Ralph.
Okay.
Are the Eve people are here and they're just not talking or what?
Lank was here. I think they forgot and they accidentally brought up a spreadsheet instead of Mumble.
That's just OPSEC. Probably not talking because it's OPSEC.
Is there another group That's being right. formed?
I think, did Never start a group?
I can drop and... Okay, Never started a group. Okay.
If anyone's taking photos, especially as you guys start your march, hashtag AIE Guild on Twitter is a place where it's fun to show off what our guild's got going on.
I'm in Crossroads, just need an invite.
Is whoever's creating the second group, if you want to invite, I'll drop from this one so that I can summon, if that's what we want to do.
Whisper Never Ending. And I'll invite you guys.
Welcome to Coop Cat Herding.
Meow.
Have a night was next night.
Have a
now,
second.
Now I know Grim.
Go ahead.
I know Grim, you miss me meowing and raid.
How are you, young lady?
Raiding on like two teams and yeah, like 10 on a 13 heroic, so it's nuts.
Have you figured out all your buttons yet?
Yeah, Zephy's going PvP.
All five of them? What did you settle on, Shadow or Disc?
Rook is your channel.
I'm actually going Holy in Shadow, but I'm gonna go PvP.
Oh my.
Alright guys, incoming message really quick. Somebody whispered because they want to share who they're walking for. I am going to try to not say this name incorrectly, so bear with me, okay? Misanthropic? I know I'm going to say it wrong. Misanthropic says that they are walking for a friend and student of theirs who died in Afghanistan. Their chopper was shot down. Master Corporal Daryl Jason Preed, or Pride, I'm not sure. Combat photographer like him, thank you.
Thanks for that.
Somebody's a robot.
Sorry.
I'm going to read the post that Patcham's wife put on the forums for those who didn't see it.
Thanks.
Tabitha is Patcham's wife. Raluk and Patcham were friends in real life, so he has allowed me to use his login information to convey the news to everyone. Patcham hasn't been around in the last 5 years, but he talked about this guild and you guys fondly, especially the Australian guy. You are a hoot, apparently. Sorry, I can't remember your name. Kyle died December 31st, 2015. That's Patcham. At 1:25 p.m. of kidney disease. He loved this guild, and to be honest, if he hadn't met me and I hadn't made real world more interesting and beautiful to him, we would have stayed very active on WoW. He loved you guys, and because of that love, you have the right to know what happened to him. He knows how to get a hold of me if any of you want to reach out and talk to me. Kyle was a good husband, friend, cleric, and father until the end. He had fun with you guys, and he was very proud to be a member of AIE, the Dias Cast.
As I just said in guild chat, this is Grimcow. My real name is Devin, and I'm walking for a friend of mine named Devin. I'm 5'11 and very Irish English. He was 5'4 and very Antiguan, but I was always the taller one, trademark. But we were always in an inseparable pair, and he passed away from cancer a couple of years ago, and I'm walking for him.
As always, I'm walking for my grandmother, who today is her birthday. She would be 94 today.
Happy birthday to her.
Happy birthday, Grandma.
We have a few more people going to join us here, and then I think we'll get ready to walk to Orgrimmar.
Okay.
If anyone's in the second group, could you come click to the summoning portal?
Is TAC on?
No. Where's the summon portal?
It's behind the angel.
I accidentally put the first one right in front of her, so I'm trying to be a little better with the placement.
Tack's not able to be here tonight to run it, but we have he lined up some backups for it.
Oh, cool.
What was that Twitter hashtag for, like, screenshots and the like?
Hashtag AIE Guild.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, capitalize the A and the G.
And the Not I that... and the E, typically, but also...
Oh, yeah. As you see fit.
But it's not critical.
For those of you who have never been before, we now RP walk to Orgrimmar. Get your horde balloons out if you have them.
Nikali in guild chat said, I am way too shy to talk and mumble, but my stepfather died suddenly last year of heart failure with no prior warning, and I've had to take over all my mom's debts and bills since then. He was an amazing guy, and he played WoW near religiously.
Thanks, Nikali.
Not specifically here for anybody, but I would like to say that AIE is the, you know, best family that I've had in game, and seeing everybody come and share their stories it's fantastic. I love everybody here, and thank you everybody for supporting this.
Channel Netserver 008, is that Ben the Mage? Madrid entered channel. Channel, Rauna, yes.
Alright, since we're in two groups, Nevermore is going to lead her group and I'll lead our group. I put a circle over my head so you can see me.
Channel, Netserver 008. Where is that slacker jagger? Channel, CYBYL. When the WoW folks march toward Orgrimmar, I shall fly to the AIE Classes Starbase. I am flying for my late son-in-law who passed away last year.
I have switched from run to walk.
Yep, we do the walk speed.
Turn on your RP walk. Unlike running with the beef the other night.
Alright, here we go.
He went the back way.
Yep. Well, I'm so glad with all the yuckity yuck that's going on with the DDoS that we had a really good turnout for tonight. Thank you, guys.
Even better in Mumble. Thanks, everybody. Hopefully things have calmed down and we won't crash Orgrimmar when we start flying around.
If you're in Mumble and you weren't able to get in game, maybe try again. Maybe it's better by now.
Yeah, I'm in right now.
Oh, great.
I made it in too.
Yeah, it's a post, but my character is Moopal, M-O-O-P-A-L.
If you say something in guild chat, Nevermore should be able to grab you.
I'll say something in AIE LFO.
10-4.
We're just leaving the shrine now on our way to Crossroads. And we're not moving very fast.
No need for speed.
It's like a start of one of the races at like a major city event, like Max was talking about, how everybody starts like just mulling out slowly.
I think we have both entered and exited Stormwind in this at this speed.
Yep.
That was one of the best quotes from the one coupe I was in was, "Why are they walking?" Because they can.
I seem to remember that coop.
I think that quote has become rather apocryphal. I think it happened at some point in the past. We had a spy on the Alliance side and somebody was saying in trade or whatever, you know, why are they doing this? Because they can. I don't know whether it was specific to an event, but I've only been here for 5 years. I wasn't there for the epic Black Friday.
That was
fun. Why is this raid different than all others?
What? Why is what raid?
Oh, it's like they say on Passover, right? Why is tonight different than all other nights?
Right. We'll see who turns up on Friday. I hope everybody who has never done a coup before comes. And if you have done a coup before, you know how much fun it is, so you'll come back.
What's a level requirement on that?
Any level, really. But the higher the better. You're going to die a lot if you're not 100, but that's okay. We tend to all have to do a battle res and die at some point. Res sickness and die at some point.
Oh, so as Max says, that's a sacrifice he's willing to make.
Yes. I went in and checked on Vol'jin the other day, and he is now at 700 million health, but the guards are at regular level 100, so the bosses are going to be slow to kill, which gives the opposition a lot more time to come after us.
What opposition?
Well, I don't know if that means... I remember, was it after Kata launched or was after Mop launched? Taranda Whisperwind had this nasty Starfire dot that we didn't have enough healers for. It started wiping us out.
Yeah, that was with Kata. They buffed them all with Kata.
Well, and they've been buffed with the systems patch. So Lord knows what the bosses are going to do to us.
Well, one good thing with the new personal loot rules, we might actually have a chance of getting the fishing achieve in a raid.
Assuming we stop to fish. And I am a salty, so... Although people have been doing that in garrisons? With a level 3 fishing shack?
You can get salty?
Oh, no. Well, you can fish up the turtles.
Oh, yeah, it did that. I just was thinking, oh, is there a glitch that you can get the
You can't avoid the Stranglethorn fishing tournament.
I did it back when you had to win the damn thing and not just get third.
I remember helping Randy get salty.
I'm saying nothing.
So
swimming and, against the current both ways.
And I had to cast 7,500 times in Northrend to catch my turtle.
So if I was to buy Legion today, I would get a token to make a Tune 100 as well as a potentially get the Demon Hunter.
Yes.
Correct.
So I'd get two characters technically?
No.
One at 100 and one at whatever.
98?
98. Yeah,
Demon
yeah.
Hunters will be rollable if you pre-purchase by next, what, Tuesday? The 9th.
Yep.
Yeah, if you have the slots for it.
You have to have a level 70 on a server to do it.
Yeah, that's what I was asking. I'm like, so if I get the Insta 100, that counts towards my 70, which means once I can get the Demon Hunter active, I can have a Demon Hunter.
Correct.
Yep. So technically, I would be end up getting two characters out of it.
Assuming you've got, if you want to do it on the same server as all your sugar daddies.
Well, yeah. I have three characters, and all of them are all under 27. One's 27, one's like 8, and the other one's 1. I just have those two other two to hold names because I was lucky enough to get the name Peters.
Ooh. Well,
it doesn't take long to level up if you want to.
Yeah, I got the air. Like I said, somebody helped me out and set me up with a trust fund and set me up with the vendor to get all the heirloom gear. So I've been leveling it pretty fast, but I'm not doing it through dungeons. I'm doing it the hard way through questing.
Well, that's more fun, frankly.
Well, it's just so I can learn where everything is. Because, well, again, I haven't played WoW since vanilla, and I'm talking like year one vanilla.
It's not a lot slower. And they, after Cata, they revamped all the old requesting, and it is much more seamless and zone to zone to zone instead of running halfway across the world and going back again. And
I'm finding that there is a definite lack of hand-holding and breadcrumbing. I've gotten lost several times and broken quest chains almost several times.
That's because you're out-leveling zones.
That is true.
So in raid frames, Darksting is offline, but I see him talking in guild chat.
Working as intended.
So I just wanted to clarify the 100 token and the... Because if I do that, then I'll join you this weekend. And that'll, if I do that, that'll allow me to get the Demon Hunter once that becomes available.
Correct.
I'd have to pre-purchase it, not pre-order it, but pre-purchase it in order to get the Demon Hunter early.
You gotta buy correct. It.
Right.
Yeah, I've been hearing a lot about that, how the customer service is going to be inundated with tickets from people who pre-ordered and not pre-purchased.
No, yeah, like a lot of us bought it, at least the digital edition, when it became available, so that we could have the mount and the pet.
Yeah, I'm not ashamed to admit the fact that I'm buying the digital deluxe edition mostly just because I want the wings for Diablo, because it's a set of wings that I haven't been able to get for some time.
Yeah, well, and the cross gameplay, yeah.
And I know Demon Hunter and WoW is not going to be the same as Demon Hunter and Diablo. I was a little disappointed by that, but oh well.
No, they're not all using crossbows.
That's all I've been hearing from Garnt. His birthday's the 24th. And the only thing he wants for his birthday is Legion and a couple time cards.
Y'all are making me want to join WoW again, and I don't have that kind of time.
Oh, it's fun.
Same here.
This protect us.
They're giving away free ponies now.
I know, but I have a full-time job, and I'm also taking classes online.
Wait, free ponies? Where?
Didn't you hear Lank say?
Well, I certainly...
Oh, we also have rainbows in this now, too.
Yeah, I wouldn't be in WoW if it wasn't for AIE.
Well, I heard that they were giving away... There's the... Whatever that... mount is that you get for buying Legion.
Wouldn't be in WoW if it wasn't for BioWare.
Do we have a new area? Yes, Broken Isles. Oh, okay.
Can we have a guild continent that just moves around?
That would be nice.
Isn't that where you like the ship thing from SWTOR?
Well, we need a guild ship that we could sail around the seas.
There's one of them flying above friggin' Ice Crown Citadel right now. We'd go take it.
I just want Disco Karazhan for our guild housing.
Yeah.
Oh, that place... a guild Zeppelin, that's what we need.
Yeah, we need that Zeppelin that's flying around up above Ice Crown. Let's go take it. We get all our Alliance players going, kill all the NPCs, and just give it.
Send it over.
Yeah, we could
to
totally throw that to good use.
So, is there
that's
free ponies?
That's what the new outlaw rogues are made for.
So is there free ponies, or is it just kind of like the same thing as the Olympic-sized swimming pool on the roof?
You need to talk to Lank about the ponies.
Oh, did they change the character limit per server?
Yes.
Yes, they added one.
It's going to 12 on next Tuesday when Demon
Hunter
is...
Right,
no, it's available now.
It's 12 right now if you want to not have a Demon Hunter.
Or save your Demon Hunter's name.
There is that.
It's 40 on Swotor if you want to move over there.
That's per server. What's it, Max?
How many Demon Hunters can I have on Swotor?
Didn't they up it to 52
or something?
As many
as you want.
I think
it's 50 now.
It's 50 max in WoW, isn't it? But 12 per server?
Oh, yeah, per server.
Yeah, and Swotor is 50 per server.
Hey guys, what? Alana wants to read something for us.
Star Trek Online, we have Sybil at Zillil, I guess. I don't know how Star Trek works. They said that they are representing AIE Classes Fleet in STO, and they shall be flying to the AIE Classes Starbase in honor of their late son-in-law who passed away unexpectedly last year.
Oh no.
Sad.
I've been to that Starbase. I have a character in there somewhere. I've been there.
Oh, yeah, it was on there yesterday.
Thank you very much for sharing.
So if you haven't been on one of these before, when we get to Orgrimmar, there will, in fact, be some celebratory fireworks.
And some laps.
And complaints from everybody else.
Nazari, where's your balloon?
It's kind of a denial of service attack for everyone in Orgrimmar, right?
As long as I can roll in on my moose, I'm good.
Capital cities are heavily cross-realm now.
We did used to warn them before we did this every year so that they would be aware that we would all be walking into Orgrimmar. I remember the first time we did it, I think we crashed everything.
But we're only like a raid and a bit this time.
Yeah, we're not as big as we usually are, believe it or not.
And not as many people are hanging out in Orgrimmar yet.
Right?
Last time I did this, we did it on Thunder Bluff and we crashed the server.
Did that on one of the Running of the Bulls. We went into Northrend, and I guess the tower, the Wormrest Tower, is like its own server. So
yeah, Wormrest Accord.
Yeah, so we had just the tower in Northrend. Apparently, is also its own. I mean, its own instance rather.
Well, yeah, because
and so we all went into. The, we were just walking across Northrend, but we walked across those 300 characters.
It was
crashed for the ring.
It was a phase thing because depending on what part of the quest line you're on, you know.
We're all running along fine, and then all of a sudden, bam, there went the server.
Whether Chromie had given you quest X or quest Y, or Alexstrasza had given you a quest, that was the problem in Northrend, and people kept phasing out when they came up to ICC for the summoning stone.
Oh, I remember that. That was a hassle.
And to be fully phased in, there were like 100 and some odd quests you had to do in Ice Crown to get the achievement. It was a big pain in the butt. Remember back then when those 5-man quests you couldn't do on your own?
probably sounded like a great idea on the planning table.
Come help me kill this thing. Well, I remember doing jailbreak on the Alliance side. I don't know how many times for Onyxia.
On two side notes, for those of you who are playing Fallout, as of update 1.7, June and Marcy Long will no longer be essential to Sanctuary. So in other words, you can kill them.
Yes.
Thank you. Now, sorry, I know it's horrible for me to say that during Remembrance Day, but we will remember June and Marcy. No pun intended, for a long time.
Oh, yes, I remember now.
I don't. I'm confused.
It's the, I want to say, Asian couple, the part of the original grouping that you rescue and conquer. It's a small spoiler alert. But she constantly complains and he constantly whimpers.
So you could just put a plasma rifle to their head and
come into the back gate of
what game is this?
I was thinking about Fallout 4. I was thinking about making a small corral and putting a death claw cage trap in there. And then put beds in there for Marcy and June and, you know, a little breakfast in bed for the death claw.
Om nom nom nom.
Nom 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 nom. Nom 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 nom.
And make sure any turrets point the other way.
Yeah. I'll be sure to do it in the back side of Sanctuary. Where that fence is that you can't scrap.
Right, out in the back corner where you built the thing.
Yes, you know exactly where I'm talking about.
Yep.
I just need to be able to kill Talus.
And we will get our wish soon enough.
And if they enable that, I would probably be participating in Light and Dark.
Wait.
So I could roll Sorks and kill Talus.
Is this now canon or what?
What is what canon?
Like killing these?
You can kill at least one of your companions in the Shadow of Revan.
Why is everybody going up the hill? That's not the wrong way to go.
Perfect. Ralph doesn't know where he's going.
No, we
was more scenic.
We wanted to make sure everybody took the scenic route.
Well, it doesn't go to the
doesn't
back
even
gate.
Go that way. So
leaving. No, it goes to the next zone.
We fixed it.
River.
Another thing I'm seeing here, apparently Suicide Squad's not getting great reviews. What a surprise.
I was afraid of that.
What a surprise. I mean, the trailers look great, and I'm sure the acting from at least a few of the people will be awesome, but it's how they put it together.
At least two.
Yeah.
It seemed like it was going to be a tough one to pull off.
So Elite Average entered channel.
It's the story's a little bit disjointed. Tough one for DC to cop. Off.
I know we're coming up on Orgrimmar. Who organized the fireworks this year?
We got Beefmaster and the, I think it's the Ukehosen.
That's what
raid,
I heard.
Raid team.
The whole raid team took that over. I'd like to say thank you to those guys.
Yep.
Our pleasure.
That was excellent of you guys to take that on.
Yeah, taking my zucchini cumber still did provide all the fireworks for us, so we're just we didn't pay for them, we're just shooting them off.
Big props to Taka Mikazuch, my fellow Canadian.
Oh, I forgot to grab Canada. My fireworks for SWTOR.
Yay, Canada. Hey?
Yes.
Blame
we have a roll in.
I miss
TAC,
you, Canada.
TAC, aka Larry, does this every year.
Oh, Canada.
And he couldn't be here tonight, so others have taken up the mantle.
Canada, my home away from home.
America's hat.
America's toque.
More precisely, yes. Depending on the time of year. You don't wear toques in the summer.
Yeah, they just wear beanies
during
the summer.
Speak
for yourself. It's because it's like 40 degrees up there.
Unless you're Justin Bieber.
Or Mike Nesbitt.
Yeah, I love my Nesbitt.
People wear toques down here in Southern California. You can wear them in Vancouver.
Yeah, if you're a hipster.
Yeah, but Vancouver doesn't get hot.
Yes. It gets up to 40.
If it's above 60 degrees Fahrenheit outside, you should not be wearing a toque.
Wait, is that 40 American?
Well, I agree. No, Canadian, silly.
Oh, 40 Canadian is hot, right?
Yeah,
it's like 100 American.
Vancouver does not get
What's
that hot.
What's the exchange
very
It
often.
Does too.
Like once a day or once a year.
Three it's, times a year.
It's like,
it counts.
It's like Canadian beers, like you double it and add 30, right?
Something like that.
Yeah, I think so.
They use that, you know, that damn commie metric system up there.
You mean the system that everybody else in the world uses, except for the States?
Except
yeah,
for the,
all,
U- the
all
U.S.
All the commies.
The U.S.
That's where they are. They're out in the world.
The U.S., I think it's Ghana and North Korea are the only people that don't use the metric system. And your military uses
well,
it for crime
wait,
and
did
sake.
You just say the necro system?
Metric system for like, crime and sake.
I like the necro system. I want to use that measurement.
One
oh,
dead
the
foot.
Military uses it. NASA uses
okay,
it
folks.
Now, finally.
All right.
Okay.
We well, are approaching the Orgrimmar Bridge.
So, do we stop here to watch it? One time I watched on one of these hills.
Or are you inside? I've seen that done, too.
Where do you want us to be?
Last year, we went the whole way in and then did it.
Yeah. Come up to the main throne building up at the front door.
Okay. I've seen it done here, and I've seen it done inside.
We deserve to be seen.
I've got to log out, guys. You guys have a good night.
Thanks for coming.
Good night. Good night.
Later, Brew. Hope you feel better.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll be all right. All right. Take it easy, guys.
See ya.
Godspeed. See, I like the fact that 1 liter of my water weighs 1 kilogram.
That is handy.
And it freezes at 0 and boils at 100.
Right? Logic?
I use the most logical system, the FFF system.
Sea level.
What does that stand for?
It's Firkins, Fortnights, and
F.
Furlongs?
What's in the other F?
Yeah, furlongs.
Furlongs.
Okay. Gotcha.
Furlong, Fortnight, and Firkins, yes.
Fathoms.
You forgot drams and
slugs.
Stones.
Wait, are we having a wee dram?
I use the, if it burns, then you should start taking it off the stove system.
Except I do use barn megaparsecs for the measure of how much sugar is in my tea.
So, Beef, you want us up by where Vulgin is? Like the way front door?
We're going around this way, I guess. Going through the slums, and we'll come out at,
This is very scenic with all the balloons and the troll buildings.
Grommash Hold.
Okay.
Yeah, we're just going through the troll section, and we'll come out at, through the slums to Grommash Hold.
Hey, Naz got here. Hi, Naz.
Naz?
There's always one person who goes AFK, and you can't take a picture because they're standing in the middle of everybody.
Right?
I don't like this city since they rebuilt it.
Or you get people who are facing the wrong way.
You don't like all the Saronite walls? Come now.
Of course, they probably rebuilt it 5 years ago. I haven't been playing for a while.
You can tell there's nobody in the troll zone because nobody's looking at us wondering what the heck we're doing. We ran through Ironforge with 40 goblins the other night. They were all going, what?
A turn right here, right?
Left.
Correct.
I actually like a lot of the new layout.
They made it so... This was a Kata remake, and they made it that flying was necessary.
For those in Star Wars, check Ops chat. We're posing for a picture.
Do you guys have selfie cameras yet?
No.
We've had selfie cameras.
Thanks, Max.
Where is that selfie ordered?
And what? Do they have pay?
Are you following me?
Starships?
Maybe.
I'm on follow on Duras, so that's dangerous.
You guys got starships and lightsabers and all that, but you don't have selfie cameras?
We've had selfie cameras since launch.
We had
selfie cameras.
Oh, that's right. That's what the
How did I not know about this?
Hello camera is for the collector's edition.
Are you going, Ralph?
Yeah, has anyone ever used one of those?
Yeah, yes. I did at the beginning.
Ralph's just taking a long way
around. Until I got fraps.
I lost mine when I was on the speeder in an Eternity Vault.
Say, we're not following Ralph, are we?
Everybody stop. Stop.
Stop, Ralph got lost.
We're not going to the Valley of Honor or the...
Going to this big... See the big building right in front of you? We're going to
just...
Frank, isn't that where we're going?
Ralph needs to update his Azeroth map.
See, you can't find your way around here since they changed it.
He just wanted everybody to catch up.
I thought I was going here.
Bloody Garrosh.
Garrosh is dead.
True.
What?
Have we replaced him with basic campfire yet?
Fellfire.
Minus 4 stamina.
And the denizens of Orgrimmar are going, oh no, AIE's here again.
Peters, can you check Ops Chat?
What am I missing?
You were giving people crap for a minute ago.
I love that.
I was facing the right way and I was sitting down.
No, you're the only one facing the other way. There we go. Thank you.
Oh, don't forget to get a pamphlet from the people outside.
Hey, Beef, we're here in front of the hole.
I was facing forward and I was kneeled. I don't understand what the issue was, and I wasn't giving people crap.
Goblins in the front, Tauren in the back,
elves in the middle,
pandas behind the goblins. Well, the pandas are pretty tall. Us.
It's about the same height as the orc.
Do you get game time when you buy Legion, or is that separate?
I think it's separate.
They normally give you like a month, right? And then each expansion or not?
No. I didn't get any.
Not anymore.
Legion or not? Rith. Can you think of the stupid second expansion now?
Burning Crusade.
That one.
No. Lich King second expansion.
Oh.
Tanadrel entered channel.
Okay, Beef, we're ready, I guess. Which way should we face?
Oh, we're shooting. Can you see it? Yep, we're up on top shooting for you guys.
Chanango entered channel.
Oh, it's behind us.
Yay, now I see it.
It's right above.
I see you up there. Yay!
That's pretty.
I have to find a mount that matches my outfit.
I suggest a red dragon.
I'm suggesting the same thing.
Or the red dragon. I'm thinking the black dragon. Or red dragon hawk.
If anybody does not have, if you're on a lower level tune and you need a buddy mount, if you back up to the back of the raids, we'll find you somebody with a two-seater.
I will park myself at the back. Where's the shaman armor? Oh wait, this is not the raid.
I see you waving up there.
Everybody, if you haven't looked up, look at the top of Vol'jin's house.
Man cave.
Bachelor pad?
Oh, you almost shot down that the Zeppelin.
It's a lovely shot.
Has anybody ever actually ridden the top of a Zeppelin over to Thunder Bluff? Because you can just stand on it.
Yeah, you have to yell, I'm queen of the world!
Or you can dance all the way. Doesn't phase.
That's a lot of fireworks.
Talk is efficient.
Lightning counts as fireworks, right?
Sure.
If you're Sith.
That's why shamans are always the life of the party.
Hey.
I'm just wondering what someone would think if they passed by this bridge right now.
Unfortunately, guys, I have to work in the morning, so I'm gonna have to say goodbye.
Good night, Ellen.
Good night.
Good night.
Have a good night.
Good night, Ellen.
Good night to the best guild. The best guild.
Good night, Ellen.
So
which way are we going, Ralph? Counter or clockwise?
Oh, when we fly? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, sir.
Let's say counterclockwise.
It's on you.
I'm waiting for the fireworks to be over.
Oh, wait. Oh,
we're about so you may go ahead and mount up.
Okay.
There's at least one empty two-person mount back here.
Okay, time for AIE Tornado.
These mounts, you guys all have such cool mounts.
Fly! 2 laps around Vulgin's house. Fly fast like a pally.
Fly, my pretties.
And we've only got one, sort of more or less one raid in a bit doing it. We have had more. Open mic.
It would be one intimidating dance if we had more.
Oh, it has been.
People have asked, why is Orgrimmar so laggy? And somebody else answered, look up.
This looks really cool if you look at it from above.
Yeah, if you want, just shoot straight up and look down, it's kind of fun.
What are they doing? AIE is doing their daily Maori Haka. Really? Well...
I remember the first one I saw. The AIE folks were going on their war bears on a
perch.
I think that was before we had flying.
That's boss.
We've done that too. We all come back from a coop run. Everybody gets on their war bears and walks through Orgrimmar, and then starts running. We may do that Friday. You never know.
Hey, Star Wars team, why don't we bounce up to our channel and we'll wrap up our standard Tuesday mandatory fun night activities and remind people what's going on Saturday.
Thanks. You guys for joining us.
Yes.
Thanks, Max. Thanks, everybody.
Grand Paladin moved to Star Wars, The Old Republic. Stavis entered channel. Yogg entered channel. Then entered channel. Seema entered channel.
Hello, Star Wars people.
Hello.
Shadow Khan entered channel.
Good night, Soliami.
Arky entered channel. Max entered channel.
Hey guys.
Telenroid entered channel.
Oh, I'm coming back, Max and Swotar.
All right, so that was quite a bit longer than usual because of that delayed startup. So sorry about that. But I really like that event, that we do that as a whole guild. All right, what do you guys want to do?
Kill stuff.
Let's see, should we go?
Simmons@gmail.com.
Well, it doesn't matter because Conquest isn't working this week, but we could still go to Hoth and kill those bosses, which is what we were going to do for Conquest. Whoa, that was a little bit harsh. Why don't we do that? I will meet you on the guild ship. So we're mostly on the imp side here.
Okay.
Alright, so flip to an imp tune. Got it.
Also, just the notes for Saturday. If you haven't seen in the forums, it's going to be a couple things. It's going to be Stronghold Tours, and then I've got a web tool that's going to allow us to do anonymous anonymous rating 1 to 10 as we go, and I'll only see the results, and it'll be an average across everybody. And so we're going to give out prizes then for the top couple strongholds. We're going to do the same thing for costume contest for best costume. And then if there's time, if there's not time, then we're all just going to dress up in our worst costumes and have a dance party here, probably on Nar Shaddaa. So we could do Republic and Imperial. And then if there is time, we'll also judge the worst costume of the worst costume contest. There will also, so there'll be prizes for those things. We're also going to be in Plug DJ all night. If you guys haven't set up Plug DJ yet, that's a music service that's free. Everybody can jump on, and then you can set up a playlist of your own as soon as you register. And we're going to do all Star Wars songs, Star Wars or space songs, like, you know, Ground Control to Major Tom. That'd be fine. But all Star Wars and space songs all night. And if you then queue up to be a DJ, you'll get to get in there and you'll get a turn to pick a song type of thing. And finally, there'll probably be a little bit of a little prize or presents for everyone that shows up on Saturday too. So hope to see everybody there. Any questions on that?
Will there be cookies?
You know, we all know that. Oh, what did we see in the forums that ultimately the cookies, the s'mores will set you free, isn't it? Dorne base is, where do we gotta go? Drift Hills, Frostwake, Jagged Plains. One of them's at Jagged Plains, right? Oh yeah, you might need to equip your weapons, and I'm not wearing any gear. I'm moving to flagship now.
Max, please so don't equip your weapons until you get your gear.
So it's a normal night, yeah.
Yes.
All right. Coming to this.
I'm engaging the flagship. Ready? Why are we over Quesh? Here we go.
You're
flying to Hoth.
That is the question.
More invites. Why am I the only one with invite privileges? There you go. X in guild chat, and we'll get you an invite. There, I made. If you guys that I made assistants could do start doing some of those invites while I move things around here, that would be cool.
You do the invites.
You are.
You
get an invite. You get an invite. Should we just mosey our way to Hoth or summons?
We can also do a summons when we get there. I just moved the guild ship to Hoth, so if you go to the guild ship and exit.
Sounds good.
You will be there as well. I am walking back to the escape pod, because that's how I roll.
Did you find a ship droid?
An astromech?
Yes.
There, if you look, there's astromechs back here by the escape pods, right where they belong. That's by design.
Jagged Plains?
But Max, they need to be in the escape pods.
Well, there's ones in the escape pods too. They're loaded.
It's a queue.
You can't see them.
Yeah, they have to download the podcast and then enter the pods.
I was looking tonight. We're up to 154. So it's what? I guess, Tima, it's 2 weeks until...
200?
Until 3 years.
Wow.
That's amazing.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Thanks. I think. Or condolences.
I'm so sorry.
Whatever the case may be.
We need judgment lessons.
Oh, this is the right place. Look, I did that right.
How'd
it's
that
like
happen?
You've done this before, huh?
Oh, I'm still have no gear though. Hold on.
Semi right.
I'll meet you guys in a second. So, does somebody have the AirTech Coral quest? I think I do. If no one else does, but you might want to share that for anybody that doesn't have it. How many people have level 65 DVL
me
tunes on the Imperial side? Type one in ops chat if you do. One of these weeks, we're going to switch over and start doing some hard mode flashpoints on Mandatory Fun Night. Hopefully we can get maybe three groups going.
That would be awesome.
Everything is awesome. Everything is cool. We're a part of a team.
There's my bracers. They're there. Oh, that is a problem. How many people have a tank for DVO? I rolled my one of them that's going to turn into one of the 50s. I did roll a tank, but my current 65 is not a tank. My 50 is my juggernaut's up to 20 or 22 or something. So I'm going to try to get a tank before long too. So let's see. Next week though, we'll see, because next week's the new chapter. So we'll see what we're going to do for Mandatory Fun Night around that. But maybe the following week for sure, we'll do a DVL hard mode flashpoint night.
Son, why are you running from the Tauntauns?
These guys were eating my lunch.
You are level synced.
What is going on there?
Yeah, you're level synced. Don't forget.
They're like, the Tauntauns are like, I knew that Tauntaun on Eternity Vault on Bell Sabbath that you kill every week. Seriously? For no good reason.
Guys are thrashing me.
The Tauntauns revolt.
Is everybody here?
Yeah, I'm not gonna go. I'm gonna be going to sleep soon.
So okay, I'll do it.
I'll sticking around in group for the moment.
Excellent.
Did we find him?
Did we not even find him?
No, I haven't been able to find him.
Me neither. Yeah, I'm ready to heal, Max.
Hey, those cats are gonna kill you.
Was that a reality check you just gave us?
A reality check. Maybe he's dead. Let's look a little bit further south here.
Well, he should be here.
He sweeps down into this heroic area just a little bit too.
Do you want to try instant 3 or 2?
Yeah. Someone's already his password. Wait till see what they say. We've got one in instance 2 and one in instance 3. Wow, there's three maps. Oh, one PvP and two maps of this place going.
Wow.
That's pretty neat.
That was kind of fun over in the wall area today.
Yeah, it is pretty impressive.
Having never done that before.
Yeah. Yeah, that's always cool.
I joined a guild back in the day called the Warcraft Hunters Union. And we did events where we rolled up all level 1 dwarf hunters and would go places, and there would be like 300 to 400 of us, and it was awesome. And then we would level up over time to like for the next event, and then we'd be like all level 10. And then one of the events we did, we went down to the Gurubashi Arena in Stranglethorn Vale, and we had Noggenfogger Elixir, which will turn you into like, or something that would turn you either into a pirate or a ninja. And so all the ninjas got on one side and all the pirates got on the other, and we fought it out to answer the question for all time, who's better, pirates or ninjas?
And who won?
And the videos of all those events are probably still out there on the interwebs. But it was just so much fun because,
But who won?
Pirates, I don't remember. Ninjas?
You don't remember?
Really, it's irrelevant.
It means we got to do it again.
Yeah, yes.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Yeah, but we, they were pretty well planned out. I mean, he had, like, places that he wanted us to go, and then he would do, like, an edited video of it at the end, and this was frost time.
We missed last night, and wow, they did a gnome's... Running of the gnome... Oh, well, I guess we're right on him.
Are we switching instances?
To help heal these guys. Yes, to three. Don't kill him, but heal up. Heal up Dent.
Don't kill him, he's gonna kill me.
Hey, heal Dent, heal Dent. No. We shouldn't.
I'll rush him.
The intent wasn't to switch over right on top of him. Don't stand in the red circles. Tell me when everybody's here, or who's not here yet.
Yeah, it just froze for a second.
Popping cooldowns.
Dent again. Heals on Dent, heals on Mortis.
Come on, Dent.
Ouch.
As we slowly get the whole raid group in here.
You might want to run back.
Is Atlas in? Because
yes,
gonna
yes.
Heal us.
I'm healing
Dent's getting
Dent
killed
right
again.
Now. I know, I'm trying my best.
That's alright.
I'm healing too.
In tanking gear either.
Are we all in now? I think we're all in now. Is Trince?
No, I'm coming Trince. Back.
How about the instances?
Instance 3, yeah?
Yep, map 3. You can click on anyone in the raid and say travel to map 3 to get to him.
Should we attack this?
No, not yet. Don't stand in the red circles, Brother Sithmas. Can someone res Father Sithmas?
I already res death. Dent.
Like do a vanish and res, drop out of
Yeah, maybe. Okay, I'm on Dent right now. So.
I'm healing Dent right now.
Okay, I'm gonna get Father Sithmas. Oh,
okay, stay out of the red circles. Let's kill him because this other guild's waiting. They're gonna wonder what we're like taunting and.
We're just having one guy attack.
Yeah, they're gonna get a little frustrated that we're toying with them or something.
Alright, prediction.
They're switching maps right now. Stay out of those red circles. Okay, here we go, more red circles incoming. Save us! Red circle.
That was a red circle.
Boy, it's hard to see those red circles.
On, red circle.
Yep.
Okay, red circle phase is done for the moment.
No, I was looking at my health bar drop, thinking, boy, I wasn't tanking it.
How did we get objective conquest points?
I guess that's the conquest this week?
There is no conquest this week.
There is no conquest this week,
I mean,
but
it's worked up, so clearly it's worked up in a not complete
epic way.
It's incompletely worked.
So, yeah, we're not invaded in anything, but it looks like you might be able to hit your personal target, I guess, because...
Oh, I didn't get credit for the Aerotech coral.
Yeah, I didn't either. I didn't
no?
get...
And neither for priority target.
And there's no loot either.
Same.
Oh yeah, same.
It was pulled for us before we came in here.
Maybe that's
it. Still, I guess so, but that should still work. Well,
did Dan get loot?
Yeah, I got loot.
They were fighting him when I came in.
Yeah,
already,
same
so.
With me, and I did get loot, but yeah, that's weird.
Yeah, when I spawned,
but
up,
I think that's probably part of it.
Grab the aggro.
Yep, same.
All right, well, let's go kill the other one, and hopefully that'll work. Frostwake, and then go around. I think that's it, right? Or Thash and go east. I'm going Frostwing.
Is that one heroic you can use to get there quicker?
I'll keep
out. On
see you later.
Later.
Frostwake? Yes.
Yep.
And go south through, and then south and west.
We're...
Follow me.
Which one are we doing?
The cat.
The big cat?
Snowblind, okay. Yeah.
Okay. Oh, then that's Thash.
Yeah, it's that.
I think it's equal distance between them, but you can go Thash.
Well, Thash, you just go straight and you're there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, flank to Thash.
Are you going to summon when you get there?
Yeah, I can summon when we get there.
Because I haven't been to this planet.
Yeah, give me time to just do a quick respec.
You should have been to this planet. It's the best planet.
It is the best planet.
Oh, this sounds damn my favorite. They had a stronghold here. I have that in a heartbeat.
Yeah, me too.
It is the coolest planet, that's for sure.
It's the coolest planet.
Yeah, but I see what you did there. It's freezing all the time.
I know.
My very first tune, I spent 2 months on this planet. I did every single achievement.
There's a good chance that he's not going to be up since that other group was trying to get that other boss.
True, true.
And I don't see him yet.
Well, this is definitely my first tune. This is the most enjoyable planet. I think I did everything too.
I really like Tatooine.
That's my those
like
are my
Tatooine
two tops.
Also.
Tatooine is also great.
Gee, I wonder why it's everybody's favorite.
Nah, my favorite's Nar Shaddaa.
Nar Shaddaa. What happens in Nar Shaddaa stays in Nar Shaddaa.
I like Nar Shaddaa because it has colorful details.
Yeah.
Hutt Vegas. Yeah. Sometimes you want a vacation in Hutt Vegas.
Was that Ecumenopolis or something like that?
Ecumenopolis,
yeah. Yeah, like in Coruscant, too.
Yeah. He's not here.
Yeah, he's not here.
Check another map. Well, I'll check map one.
Remember, whatever you bring to Nar Shaddaa stays in Nar Shaddaa.
That's right.
Yep, in Carbonite. Wow, Seema, when did you get your Marauder to 65?
He is not here on one either. It boggles my mind that every time we come to kill world bosses, there's other guilds out killing them.
You know what? There didn't used to ever be anybody killing them. When they were low level.
I'll be right back.
Didn't anyone check two?
That's PvP, man. PvP. I'm not going over there. I get killed.
Never anybody there. It's the safest place in the game.
I'm going there.
I can't switch for 10 minutes.
Oh, got it.
To two.
Yeah.
Until someone else gets there, I think.
I'm just taking the speeder around to unlock as much of the planet as I can.
Something just hit my window, like a very large bug or a bat, maybe. It's
monsters are trying to get in.
You mean the window on your speeder?
Stranger Things.
Stranger Things, yeah. The upside down. Down.
I haven't watched that show yet.
It's really oh, it's great. Very, very, very
is
great.
It?
I just finished the second episode today.
If you lived, if you're sort of a kid of the 80s, especially, it's amazing. And I've heard people describe it this way. I was reading a thread on Reddit. And it's not that it like has a bunch of 80s references. It's that it's set in like the real 80s. And you get like flashbacks to your childhood. It's just...
Oh, that's nice.
It's really like, well done.
I was like, you know, I remember when it was scary to go out at night because you didn't have like, you know, any way to contact people.
He is up on two?
He is up on two.
And who switched to two?
Dent.
So you,
we're coming. You, oh wait, am I in the right spot?
Oh, I still can't.
I'm gonna back up.
Seema, see if you can summon when you get there, because okay. It's not letting me switch.
We don't need you.
This is true.
Hey, is it two?
It says I cannot switch focus. Oh, until 9:49. I see. Until 9:49 p.m. I thought it was saying for 9 hours and 49 minutes. Oh.
Oh man, it sent me all the way back to the outpost thrash.
Oh yeah, because it's a PvP. Because
it's PvP. Yeah.
I'm just gonna
summon everybody here, and then we can move out together.
Okay.
Okay, guild summon's coming right now.
Well, I took a bunch of pictures. We got some good ones. I will post them.
So I took the summons to... Yeah. Okay.
Who's that? What?
Nothing. I misinterpreted. I misinterpreted what you were saying. So when I wound up only like 5 feet behind you, I was surprised.
All right. I guess we're all here.
Roll out. Who's shooting the Tauntaun?
It's always Thon. Thon's shooting the Tauntaun.
Thon.
Now that's a great idea for another tune. I can't believe I never thought about that.
That your D-back's gonna freeze.
He's a winter dewback.
Yeah. He should be using the planet appropriate mount, man. Come on.
Oh, come might, on, man. I have a winter Ackley.
You might think that's a really hot name, Thon, but to me, it's lukewarm.
Oh my god.
I did actually come up with another one today. I gotta see if I can gear it out to make the look match the name. So we'll see. So on the costume contest, is it one entry? You have to pick your best?
Probably just for purposes of time.
Yes.
But I will be happy to take pictures of honorable mentions.
What, you don't have time for all 80 of mine?
Exactly.
So are you going to do pancakes?
No, we probably won't unless we get bored and don't have anything to do. I figure if we do stronghold tours and costume contests, the bouncing between people's strongholds and getting it all done, it'll take us quite a while. So anybody who doesn't know what... are we all here? We're all here.
What time are we doing the stronghold deal?
8 p.m. We'll start everything around 8 p.m. Central.
Unfortunately, I can't make it. Makes me sad.
What's the dude walking around behind him?
He's cleaning up after him or something.
What is that guy?
He's got the super duper pooper scooper.
He's just on follow, and he's just walking around behind him.
It's like the circus guy.
Is he linked? I'm gonna shoot him.
I think he's linked.
My trainer. Pull. I've never noticed that.
Pulling.
1, 2, 3, pull.
Pull. Whose dent is tanking?
Yeah, I'll
tank
it.
Back. Stack up on dent when, not doing that much damage. Who's over there, Erato?
Yeah. I stay out of the way, basically.
Yeah, I'll just have to throw some heals on you. But I'm not healing tonight, so. So if you die, I'll try not to laugh too hard.
Oh, no problem. I'm used
when
to
it. When I'm healing, I take people's deaths pretty hard. But when I'm not healing,
I never do that.
Unless it's your own death.
Well, then I rage quit.
Best thing to do.
He said doo-doo. Yeah.
Business as usual. That's my secret. I'm always angry. Alright.
Well, I've been having some fun tanking on SOL.
Yeah, you like that?
It is really hard. Harder than healing, I think.
I think you may be right, yeah.
Until you get used to it. I mean, I think healing's harder for me right now. Than
healing
tanking.
Is really easy if the content is easy, but it's the hardest job if the content is hard.
I find that healing's technical rotation, doing the right thing at the right time, difficult. But tanking is strategy hard also. It's less of the other part. And there's only so many, your damage abilities don't really matter. You're just keeping up threat, and then you're using your cooldowns at the appropriate time. But being in the right place at the right time, positioning the boss correctly, figuring out where everyone else is, and that's
But that's also, like, you think of healing as, like, you get to shoot your comrades all day.
Well, that's fun.
I started out the game doing tanking and DPS, it took me a while to get into healing.
Executable.
Yay!
Like clockwork.
Conquest. A lot of conquest points. Was it a one-time? Well, who knows?
Not a lot. I only got 2,000 for both of those.
I received a credit.
Congrats on levels.
All right, guys.
It got me, Tom.
Not too much tonight because we did the big remembrance event, but I think Seema and I need to drop off and prep for the podcast. I don't know if you saw the news, they're adding a new little feature to the game for mostly for opening cartel packs, but it'll work for the DVL packs as well, and it's a really nice interface. In fact, I want them to add put that style of effort into the GTN and a bunch of other things. But
what is it that they're doing?
Does it change what's in the pack?
What's in the box?
So when you open a pack, so every pack in your inventory, when you want to open packs, you'll open a pack opening interface. And then all the packs you have in your inventory will show up on the left in a nice column. And then as you open packs, there's a nice animated, you can either open like a bunch at once or open them one at a time. And there's a nice animated thing. And then the coolest part is everything that you get out of a pack then goes into a temporary holding called Stash, which is legacy. It's sort of like legacy storage for cartel pack items. And it all stays in the stash until you take it out into your inventory from whatever character you want to take it out on.
So how is this? So it's not going to be reverse compatible like anything that we've opened in cartel packs or legacy packs previously.
No.
Right. No, you can't take an item and that you already have. In fact, once you take these items out of the stash, you can't put them back in.
Right. Right.
Does the timer go away if you leave it in a stash?
No. You have to have it in your inventory to start the timer.
Okay.
So how long does it, or how big is the stash?
Yeah. 250 items, yeah. I think.
And oh, how long nice. Can you keep something in your stash?
Until you need the room, yeah.
And because it's legacy, the things in the DVL packs that are bound items, like, you know, black
oh,
dye.
That's nice.
Oh, that is good.
Then you can get them for any character.
So do you get the feeling that they're trying to encourage people to buy cartel packs?
I've never gotten that feeling. What? Where would that come from? That's strange.
Yeah, well, but you know what? People weren't complaining about what's in how to open the packs. They were complaining about what's in the packs.
Right. Yeah. Well, this is specific. I think it was one of the reasons it was put in was specifically to solve this issue that they had with the way the DVL packs were working and being able to move that stuff around. But that's not an invalid point of. It does seem like some significant design effort went into this because it's one of the nicer interfaces that they've built in a long time. Hey, wouldn't it have been nice if they had done that for a couple other things that we actually care about a little bit more?
I wish they would do something for those of us that have like opened all of our Dark versus Light packs already. Like, because now, like, those of us that have gone ahead and done all the things are...
Right.
Yeah, because now you can't get them because they're bottom.
Right. I'm sure you're not the only person who's thinking that, and yeah.
And I'm not trying to sound like, you know, Debbie Downer or anything, but I mean, yeah, I kind of feel cheated now.
Right, because you embraced the event, you went forward with it, and now you're done with the lion's share of it, and they made this change. I get it.
Well, I'm sure there's going to be more packs in the future, though.
Hey, when Chapter 16 comes out, I'm going to just, you know, unlock the packs on the same tune and just hope I get Revan's Bottoms and, you know, get the complete set, you know. That's fine.
But if you have ever opened up, like, a 30... pack or something, your inventory gets filled so fast that it's really annoying, so this will be nice in that.
Not having to worry about your inventory slots in your stronghold, like not your stronghold, in your you know, ship bay, like being full of like packs and having to roll tunes to hold new cartel packs.
Exactly.
And speaking of that, you know, opening 30 crates, they also did a thing in the stash where if you get multiple items of stuff, even if they're not traditionally stackable items, they still only take up the one slot in the stash.
And packs in the interface and in your inventory now stack also.
But you can still choose to open one.
Yes. All right, I am out for now. I will catch you guys
in a bit
on one of the ops nights or Saturday for our guild party.
All right.
Later.
Poorly, Beck Hesh, moved to Nomads.